Jackson for the inaugural address.
What a great honor to be able to introduce for the first time ever
Only, it's only a game. Why you have to be mad?
You know what's sad? Somebody in the comment section is going to take that intro seriously. What's going on, you guys? TBR here, back yet again with another King of Fighters All-Star video. And happy Saturday to all of you. It, of course, is going to be the Saturday Chat and Chill. But before we get into all of that and more, if you guys haven't already done so, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe, as we are on the road to 3,000 subscribers by the end of 2021, and you could help us get just that much closer. So let's go ahead and get into this week's topic, because it's going to be a doozy, and I might upset some people. Oops. Now, before we get into the actual topic at hand, there is something that I do want to kind of talk about, and then I'll kind of tie it all together with a nice little bow at the end. Well, there won't be a bow, but I will tie it all together. But I want to talk about the new Team Relay dungeon, and of course that is going to be Zombie Rod, or Rob Zombie, or whatever you want to call him. But when it comes to Zombie Rod, this Team Relay dungeon, a lot of people have been complaining about, a lot of people have been upset about, and in particular, it's a lot of people who are, I get the feeling, somewhat new to the game. Because I'm going to be honest with you guys, and if you're not in my Discord, then I highly recommend that you guys jump in there. I'm not even saying that because I really honestly couldn't even tell you exactly how many members I have in the Discord. I really don't care, to be honest with you. I'm really just saying that because if you need help, then honestly, that's the place you should be. But I digress. I've had a lot of people in the Discord asking questions about the Zombie Rod Team Relay, and to be honest with you guys, after talking to Gunny, after talking to several other people, after helping numerous people in my DM, with questions on this thing, all I can tell you guys at this point is that this thing really isn't as difficult as you guys might think it is, and actually it might come down to you guys making some mistakes on your end that you may not even realize you're doing. So I am going to be putting together a guide to help kind of tie together everything that I have pretty much figured out about it, and all the things that everybody else has figured out about it, and try to put it all into one video. I had made the attempt at maybe trying to get that video done for today, but with everything I had going on yesterday, I was not able to get that video together because it was already around 25 minutes and I was only able to maybe get 15 minutes of audio done on it. So you guys will be seeing that guide here in the next couple of days, but it does still have some time to cook, so keep that in mind. But I do want to give you guys out there a little bit of hope, because it really isn't as difficult as you might think. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and do you all a solid. I'm going to leave some links in the description of this video that is going to be to other YouTube videos showing you guys some different teams that have gotten through it, as well as showing you guys that you really don't need high investment versions of these characters in order to get through this thing. Honestly, you can do it with characters that are Awakening level 1 if you really just want to invest into the imprint stones for the characters, because that's the easiest way to buff that CP. Make sure that you guys are turning off awaken auto use in your settings, because that will screw you up in a big way. And the biggest thing that I found that a lot of people are messing up on, make sure that you're actually hitting the boss, because a lot of people make the mistake of being towards the bottom or the top of the screen. I'm actually going to have a clip in this Saturday Chat and Chill today that is going to show several examples of that, so maybe pay attention to that. But outside of that, I will be doing a guide and I'll show you guys as much as I can in that, so stay tuned for that video. But the best advice I can give you shorthand right now is just approach it like it's an immortal dungeon. You're going to be trying to stop the clock as much as possible. And like I said, guys, all you got to do is try to build these characters up to some discernible amount, and you should be okay. I've seen people clearing this thing with one-star awakened characters. I even saw a guy on the forum. Yes, guys, I braved the damn forum, and somebody had actually cleared it with, I think there was like a 2 level 88 characters on their team or something. So, you guys, it's really not as difficult as you might think. It comes down to the fact that it's just going to require a little bit of effort, and it's going to require a lot more strategy than you might might be used to if you're used to just being a meta slave for a lot of these characters that are just like, oh, I push buttons to kill things. It's going to require a little bit more effort than that. And that's actually going to tie a little bit into the topic at hand here, because the topic I'm going to talk about today doesn't necessarily just pertain to the King of Fighters All-Star community. So, gosh, guys, it's not always about you. Come on. But this actually is a much broader topic, but I figured I would use Zombie Rod as a good example that's kind of a at-home one. That way you guys would kind of know where I'm coming from with this. But I've seen for months and months and months now, there has been a couple of topics of conversation that Zombie Rod actually covered that I thought, honestly, a lot of people out there would be very happy about. One is, of course, going to be the fact that this dungeon makes gold border characters relevant. Yeah, you have to use gold border characters for it. You have to build up gold border characters for it. You actually have to use specific ones, and they themed it after the actual holiday, which, of course, makes sense. But, of course, people don't like that. People think that that is bad. People think that that's stupid because they feel like it's a situation where, you know, everybody should be able to have equal opportunity at this stuff. Well, I don't agree with that. And I don't care if people disagree. I'm going to tell you guys right now, somebody that just downloaded this game, like literally yesterday, does not deserve the same amount of stuff as somebody that downloaded this game on day one. I'm sorry, but that's just not how the world works. In fact, I would argue and wager that you have to earn things in life. And yes, video games aren't life, but it is a good microcosm example, and it's the same basic idea. You can't just walk into something and expect everything to be handed to you. So I understand that if there are people out there that are, let's say, veterans who can't get through this, I could understand why they'd be pissed. But I genuinely believe that it's more of a situation for the veterans and the intermediates, some of the intermediates, probably not all of them, because I can understand for some people it being very difficult for them. But for some people in those two categories that can't get through it, it's more of a situation where they probably are either A, doing something wrong, or B, have the answers already. They just need to put them together like a puzzle and might just need the right guide. So I totally understand those different camps of those people and their feelings towards things. The people I don't have any sympathy for, and I really don't care if they can't complete it or not, are players that just downloaded the game, because guess what? Those players don't need to, they shouldn't have to. Like, it isn't a situation where they should even be able to. They shouldn't be able to just download the game and beat everything and have everything. What's the point of playing this game for any discernible amount of time for building up these characters to make your account stronger? Any of this stuff, if every single time they release any bit of content, any Joe Schmo off the street can just download the game and get it. What are we playing for at that point? What are you earning? You're not earning anything. You're just being handed everything. Like, what's the point? We sit here and we talk about all the time how there's no challenging content in the King of Fighters All-Star. And then they go ahead and they release something that's slightly challenging. I'll even say slightly challenging, even though I don't even think it's really that. It's just more so that you need to be somebody that's played the game long enough to have some of these characters. But then people complain about, oh, well, it's a real small pool of characters. I haven't built those up. I don't have those characters. Well, it's a Halloween event. I think we can all understand that it's a Halloween event. If it were a situation where this was out of season and we were getting this in, say, I don't know, April, yeah, I would say, yeah, that's kind of stupid, but it's a Halloween event. So who cares? Like, it's just, to me, it's mind-boggling. It is absolutely mind-boggling. And then there's going to be the people that are going to be like, oh, well, they gave us Boss Syndrome memories easily earlier in the year, and now we can't really get them outside of doing this kind of stuff, and yada, yada, yada. Well, yeah, things change. It kind of sucks, but at the same time, you gotta think about it from their perspective, too. Like, a Boss Syndrome generic memory, really, if you think about it, that's like 18k worth of rubies of content right there. Like, that is worth quite a bit to them. And so, even though I don't agree necessarily with the way that they've done things with it, it's one of those situations where I don't really have an issue with it on paper. I feel like if it's a situation where they want to start giving this out to people who have really donated a lot of time and effort into the game, and they want to make it a bit of an incentive for other people out there to start building up their characters and start really kind of thinking about these things and, you know, trying to challenge themselves and build characters they wouldn't necessarily have built before for things like this, then go for it. Like, right now you guys should probably be worrying about making sure you build up or collect the Christmas fighters, because there's a good chance that come December this might happen again. But it's a situation where I just don't understand where people come from. Like, why do you feel like every new player off the street deserves everything? Maybe I'm old school, but I don't see any issue with a video game company releasing something like this that is going to be challenging, that is going to require some thought, that is going to require some strategization, that is going to require people to come off of some of their resources and build up characters they wouldn't normally have even looked at. I mean, let's be honest, guys. Would anybody outside of Alice and Chris looked at any of these other Halloween characters if this relay dungeon hadn't existed in the first place? Probably not. So it's a situation at the end of the day where this is very rewarding for people who have been investing in all of these different characters for a very long time. I mean, I've been playing this game since day one. I can remember when Halloween Kula was the meta in PvP. So in the end, it's a situation where I do feel like, yes, it kind of sucks for some people out there, but at the same time, I feel like there is a very vocal minority of players in this player base that are pissed off about this, because I do think that the majority of people understand it and don't have an issue with it, but that minority has a problem with just always expecting Netmarble to hand them everything. And at the end of the day, I cannot agree with that mindset. And I'm going to give you guys an example, a perfect example, and there are plenty that you could look towards over the past several years, because it seems like this topic and conversation comes up every several months, and I still to this day can't wrap my head around it. And that is, of course, video games are just too challenging now. Well, I'm sorry to tell you, buddy, but honestly, I feel like video games have gotten a lot easier over the years. I mean, I grew up on Super Nintendo, PlayStation, N64, Dreamcast, all of these systems when I was younger. And those video games were absolutely punishing, and they made you earn everything. You were not just handed anything, and you actually had to go in and strategize and learn and adapt to all of these different things. And if that meant that you left teeth marks in your controllers, if that meant that a controller went through a window, then so be it. But at the end of the day, you had to do what you had to do to get the stress out when you were trying to get through some of these bosses, right? Well, nowadays, people act like, well, if there's not an easy mode, or they don't just hand this to me, then this is bad content. The developer sucks. Like, where are you coming from? I'm going to give you guys a good example, and it's another one that is something that is personal to me, because I've been playing the hell out of Metroid Dread, which, yes, it is amazing, thank you very much. But people have been complaining that it's too difficult. But if these are the same people... No, let me back it up a little bit. These people are complaining it's too difficult because they don't know where to go. They don't know where they're supposed to go. Well, these are also the same people that go on Twitter, which is basically just another word for cancer. They go on Twitter, and then they post, Samus is my favorite video game character. I love the Metroid franchise, but Metroid Dread is just too difficult. There is no indication of where you should go, and I just want the Morph Ball already. Have you ever played a Metroid game in your entire life? I guarantee you that these are the same people that post these types of things. These people have never played another Metroid game. They simply know that Samus is a female, and that is all they care about. And then they act like they are the world's biggest Metroid fan, when they couldn't even tell you the difference between Super Metroid and Metroid. I guarantee it. Because I feel like if they were actual Metroid fans, they would realize and understand that exploration and trying to figure out where the hell it is you're supposed to go and getting lost are all part of the appeal of the franchise. But, you know, at the end of the day, it is what it is. So I wanted to use that as another kind of example, because I'm sure you guys are aware of plenty of them in the past several years, because it's been a hot topic of conversation. Video games all need easy modes, and all video games are too difficult nowadays, and yada, yada, yada. And I'm not going to get too much into that topic in this video, because I do want to just kind of throw it in here as a way to kind of reinforce what I'm talking about, while at the same time not trying to go too far off the beaten path. I could do an entire video ranting about this topic if I really wanted to, but I'm not going to do that. So, in the end, to summarize, and I guess this is where I put the bow on everything, you have to decide at the end of the day what kind of gamer you are. Are you the type of gamer that accepts a challenge and likes a challenge and finds beating a challenge to be fulfilling? Then, if you are, then these types of things are definitely going to be for you. Or are you the type of player that just wants to be handed everything and doesn't really want a challenge? Really, it's just about the power fantasy and kind of just mindlessly being able to play something and waste some time for a little bit, and then you put it down and don't come back to it till later. But whatever the case may be, there's all sorts of types of gamers out there. I know what kind of gamer I am. I enjoy the challenge. I enjoy having to figure things out and having to solve puzzles and do all of these things that you would normally come to expect from playing a video game. But at the same time, I can also be big enough to accept that there are people out there that are going to differ. The only thing that bothers me is when people try to ruin it for the rest of us, and that's really kind of where it comes down to for me at the end of the day, because I don't really feel like challenging content is a problem. I don't feel like it's a bad thing, nor do I feel like creating content specifically for players and rewarding players for playing the game for a long time, or at least a longer amount of time than maybe a week or a month. I don't feel like that's a bad thing. In fact, I feel like that just cultivates and maintains the people who have been around for a very long time and keeps them engaged and keeps them interested. But then again, I could be wrong. So I've never professed to know everything. At the end of the day, I'm only human. I'm just another guy on the internet. So anyway, you guys, that is going to be what I have to say about all of this. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe. Like I said, I will try to get a guide out to you guys over the course of the next couple of days. But with all of that being said, I hope you all enjoy your weekends. And if you can take anything from this video, well, take this.
It's only a game. Why do you have to be mad? Continue.